Put God first, Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment. The best makeup artist, Candy 2423950125.
You don't even know how very special you are.
Self-care has been defined as the process of establishing behaviors to ensure holistic well-being of oneself, to promote health, and to actively management of illness when it occurs. Individuals engage in some form of self-care daily with food choices, exercise, sleep, and dental care.
Stop. Just stop. 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 You are going to end up burning yourself out, trying to be there for everybody else, but don't have enough time for you. What about self-care and self-love for you? I know you've been super mom or dad. I know you've been super daughter or son. I know you've been super wife or super husband, but stop. When do you block out the world and say, I need to make sure I'm good? Because if you don't make sure you're good, watch this, you won't be good for nobody else. So I know this is not the TikTok you really wanted to see, but I'm saying stop. You're digging yourself inside a hole. Stop. You're drowning your own self. Stop. You're mentally overwhelming your own self. You're bringing anxiety on your own self when anxiety is just a down payment on something that may never happen. I don't know who needs to hear this, but focus on you. Love you more. Give you some alone time so you can mentally be okay for everybody else. Stop. Stop. Stop being there for everybody else. And just take out a little bit of time for you.
Me say this year people are going to catch heart attack, and when the doctor do the autopsy, they're going to find that the cause of death was a bad mind. You know why? Because a long time people count out some money, you know, and them feel like except from COVID-19, you know, should have dropped out and dead and become nothing. But see, the 2023 is still going strong. Big up yourself.
God will find you. Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment Perfected Faces done by Candy.
See, I didn't find God in the church. In fact, I didn't find God at all. He found me. He met me in a place where I was so broken, I couldn't get up. And when you're loved like that, it will shock you.
Whoever needs to hear this, listen now. God did not bring you this far to leave you. He did not bring you this far to... The scripture says that he that started a good work, he starts a good work, he's faithful to see it through till the end. The work that the Lord has started in you is a good work, and he will surely see it through to the end. He says he makes all things work together for good for those that love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. You did not find God, contrary to the way it explained today, that I found God. You did not find God. God was not lost. You was lost. God found you. And so if he finds you, he is big enough, strong enough and able enough to secure you and to keep you. Got to believe that. In the book of Matthew chapter 6 verse 44, it says, no one can come to you unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day. Christ is saying that if the Father did not send you, if the Father did not send you to him, you will not be able to know him. So God found you. So you've got to believe that if he found you and he's brought you this far, then he's faithful enough, he's able enough, and he's more than willing to see you through to the very end, because he does a good work. He doesn't do unfinished business. No. The Lord finishes his work perfectly. The book of Ephesians 2 verses 10 says that we are God's masterpiece. We are God's masterpiece. Listen to these words. Created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared for us a long time ago. So before you were even born, there was a preparation for you. You've got to believe that because it's true. Before you even says, before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew you, I'd set you apart. Right? So there's a preparation for you, there's a plan for you, there's a purpose for you, there's a path for you. And you are a masterpiece that is going through to perfection. You will be perfected. You're going through a process that is going to take you to perfection. The Lord did not bring you this far to leave.
God wants to be pursued. He's a relational God. He's a jealous God. He wants your heart. He wants your devotion. He wants your passion. In fact, he gives us an incredible promise in Jeremiah 29, verse 13. He says this, God says, you will seek me. And what happens when you seek me? When you seek me, he says, you'll find me. It's a promise. If you pursue God, he will reveal himself to you. You will seek me and find me. When you seek me with all your heart, God says, I will be found by you, declares the Lord. When you draw near to him, when you pursue him, when you crave him, when you hunger for him, God loves to be pursued and he loves to reveal himself to you.
To speak to people about a peg. So when you look at a peg, Sister Lerato, there's this silver spring in the center.
Yes.
A peg cannot function without the silver spring in the center. If I remove the silver spring in the center, it'll be just two pieces of planks that mean nothing. Same thing with your life. If I remove God at the center of your heart, you'll be a meaningless person. You wouldn't know your purpose. You wouldn't know your calling. You wouldn't know who you are. Number two, when you hang clothes on a line, why do you put a peg? You put a peg so that impacts a zinga or a zinga gold. Same thing with your life. Why do you receive God in your life? You receive God so that you don't fall into depression, anger, anxiety, bitterness, jealousy. That is why you need God in your life, so that you can be who you are and know your identity and purpose. Number three, if I remove the clothes from the pegs, so that is why it's very important to stick onto the Lord. Number four, Apex does not discriminate, Sister Lerato. It doesn't matter whether you are rich, whether you are poor, whether you are filthy, whether you are dirty. Apex's job is to hold you. It does not matter who you are. Apex is going to hold you. Isn't this is the same thing that God says? Come as you are. It doesn't matter how broken. It doesn't matter what happened in your life. God is saying that just come as you are. Right now, during this lockdown, there's somebody that's broken. It's saying that I have no future. There's no hope, Bungan. But I want to tell you, God is saying, come as you are. And the word fear, Sisley Rato, the word fear, this word, fear, it has two meanings for me, Sisley Rato. It says, first meanings from the enemy. And people will say, forget everything and run away from the promises that God has for you. It's saying forget. But I want you to turn it around today. I don't care what situation you're facing today. Turn it around. Face everything and rise. I don't care what situation you've been through. A lot of people, they might have thrown stones. Dogs do not bark at a car that stands still, but dogs bark at a car that's moving. So what I'm telling you, run, hustle. It's difficult. Today I'm an author, Sister Lerato. My friends, when I shut my
wish you could trade eyes with me. Because there's complexities in complexion, but your skin is glow like diamonds. Dig me like the earth, you be giving birth to everything alive, baby, know your worth. I love everything about you, from your nappy curls to every single curve, your body natural. Same skin that was broken, be the same skin taking over. Most things are to focus you, but when you're in the room, they notice you. You in all of your glory. Your skin is not only dark, it shines and it tells your story. Keep dancing. can't control you.